I welcome eminent speaker Dr. Amit Kumar Mishra, all dignitaries and participants. On last day of 3-day faculty development program on role of latex in scientific writing. The previous session was very interesting and informative, and I hope it was fruitful for all participants. Proceeding of today's session will be the talk given by Dr. Mishra, then question answer round, followed by vote of thanks by our convener. Now, for today's session, it's my pleasure to invite Dr. Mishra Bans.
Thank you, Ankit sir. Good morning to all of you. So today we are going to discuss many important things. My plan is to discuss. My plan is to discuss first how to write references, and then I will discuss how to prepare slides or presentations. Then I'll discuss one template of book, then mathematical typing and chemistry typing. So these are my aim to discuss today. So now you the first thing is we are going to discuss how to type references in LaTeX. So document class will be article if you are typing research papers, and if you are book, then you may also have references, so reference can anywhere. So you can type reference in your document file. Otherwise, you can prepare a separate file for reference. So I just have prepared a file, and I will show that file, and then I will discuss how to prepare that kind of file. So you can see there is a file references.bib, B-I-B is the extension, which is bibliography. So am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And
yes,
the screen
sir.
Is visible?
Okay, sir. Okay. Sir, visible.
Okay. Yeah. Then how to type references? One thing is you remember this command, which is more or less always difficult. So don't remember these commands, just understand what it says. So it starts with @article. That means you are typing a journal article, and then you always provide a key. This is known as key. So I have provided a key Boland 1992, for example. So this key will be very important, because you will actually use this key to refer this article. Then you write down the name of authors, title of your paper which you want to cite, year, journal, volume number, and then number and pages. Now remember, all these things you are typing in inverted commas. That is important. Then similarly, you can enter many articles which you want to cite in your research, research article, and you can also have manual or you can also have book. So you know that in books we have author, title, year and publisher, address of the publisher. So these options are there. So first thing is you have to print this reference file with extension .bib. After that you can use this file in your main document. And remember that please always save the file in the same folder where your main file is there. If you do not do this, then you have to provide the path, which may be not very good or which may be difficult. So I always put this file into the main file. So this was So another method is you can have bibliography menu. You can choose bibliography menu and here insert bibliography entry. If you care, then you can have name of the file or there may be new file. Then, for example, you want to enter article in journal. Just click on that and write down, fill all these columns which are of your interest. For example, ID means this must be unique, then authors, then title, then journal title, date, and many other things. So you can prepare your bib file directly from menu bar also. Another thing is, if you are using Google Scholar, then there is an option. For example, if I open Google Scholar, and in Google Scholar, you type, for example, a note on active redundancy and search the paper.
Sir?
Yes, yes.
Sir, aapki awaaz kuch beech mein, aapki awaaz kat ja rahi hai beech mein, sir.
Beech mein do teen baar disconnect hua hai.
Ji, sir, thoda sa disturbance aa raha hai.
Ji, abhi aa rahi hai?
Ji, sir, thoda sa.
So you search the article in which you are interested. For example, I am searching my own article, a note on active redundancy allocations in K out of N systems. It was AK Mishra, Neeraj Mishra, and it was published in Statistics and Probability Letters. Now, if you click on this question mark, this apostrophe, inverted comma 2, then you can see it has shown you site. So just click here. It will give you this BibTeX. So if you click again on BibTeX, then just copy this and paste it in your a reference file. For example, I am pasting here. So if you do not want to type these things, you can use the help of Google Scholar, which will give you all these things. And then you save this file. Now, after preparing your reference .bib file, you now prepare your main file. So now we are having main file, document class, article, then you write down begin document. Now, if you want to cite something, so you write down C and the command is / cite and the key which you have written. For example, Boland 1975 and cite Mueller 2002. Or you write down site, start inverted comma, then you can have list of all the references. So you select any one of them. For example, I select the Misra 2007, which I have just entered. So if you run this file, then you see, I think, yeah. Now you can see here, this is the third article. 1, 3, 4 detailed 2. So second article is Amit Kumar Misra by and Neeraj Misra, which I have recently added. And the first article is Ari Borlo, and second article is this. You can see this will refer as well as it will provide the references on last page. So this is the way we write down the references. But if you see, it is written in there is network problem, it is continuously disconnecting. I just repeat what we are doing. So I have prepared a reference file, and then I am using that reference file here. How to use that? You just write down bibliography style plain and bibliography reference. So reference is the name of the file which you have prepared, and bibliography style is plain. Okay, so now if you use simply this, it will provide you references with numbered, but sometimes you may require author and year kind of thing. So for that we have to use a package. So I will just open a file and discuss it without typing, so that we can have more discussions. So citation and references using NatBib, NatBib package. So this is a package which allow you to use references using many options. So the you have to use this package, use package NatBib. This is the package name. And then there is an option round. So there are many options. I am using the round option. So how it works, the idea is very simple. Instead command site, which I have used here, I have used command CITE site. So site can be used if you are not using NatBib, but if you are using NatBib, then the commands are site T and site P. So site T means it will give you name with year in parentheses. And if you type site P, it will give you name and year within the parentheses. So site P stands for parenthesis, site T stands for textual. So these are the commands. So if you write down site T and the key, it will give you Boland and others and 1992. So this is the single citation. If you put star here, then it will provide you all the author's name. So site T with star provides all the author's name. Similarly, you can provide the options, for example, chapter 4. So it will give you Carlin 1968 chapter 4. So you can have combinations of these commands. So I will not discuss them one by one. But if you have multiple citations, for example, you are using site T, Walde 2003 and Kirmani 2001. So it will give you the output Walde 2003 with a semicolon, then Kirmani and Gupta 2001. And if you use parentheses, it will provide the same thing within a parenthesis. And if you are using the same name, for example, site T, Walde and Walde 2003 and 6, then it will give you the single time name and years 2003, 2006. So these are the referencing style when you use NetBib. Similarly, you can further elaborate it without parenthesis. So the command is site alt, A-L-T will be used to remove the parenthesis. So all other things are same. So remember, there are site T, site P. When you put a star, it will give you give all the names. If you put alt, it will remove the parenthesis and so on. Similarly, you can also use only author, for example, site author. So it will not provide you the name, the year of the research paper. It will only provide the name. And if you put site author star, it will provide all the names. Similarly, you can only cite year also with a command cite year. It will give you 1992. And cite year par, that means it will provide you year with parentheses. So there are many methods by which you can cite. So I will share this file with you. And the basic idea I have given you, then you have to practice it. The basic idea I will just repeat. You have to prepare your reference file, which is this way. Then you have to prepare your main file. And in main file, you have two options. One option is you use just a plain bibliography style, or you may use bibliography style plain net. Plain net means you are using a NetBib package. So when you use NetBib package, it will provide you many options. That means you can have author year citations, only authors, only year, year with parenthesis, author and year with parenthesis. So there are options. And the commands are given in this document. You can do practice on your own. So this was about referencing, which is very important topic. When you are preparing your research paper. Now, the second thing is how you prepare presentations in Beamer. So that is my next aim, how to prepare presentation. So for preparing presentation, the document class is Beamer. When you are writing article, you use article class. Now you are going to prepare presentation, then you have to use document class Beamer. So there is a method I will just show you. If you want to directly use, then you just go to wizard and quick Beamer presentation. So when you open this, it will give you theme, which is default. You can select the theme. For example, I always choose Cambridge US theme. If you have seen my day one presentation, so day one presentation was in this theme. So this is the Cambridge US theme. I most of the time use this theme. Then you can fix your font size 11 point, 12 point, 14 point. So usually I fix 11 point. Then you write down your name. For example, I am writing Dr. Amit Kumar Mishra. You can write down the title. So I can write down the title, role of LaTeX in scientific writing. And then if you are doing some mathematics, if you are using some pictures, then check AMS package and graphic package and click on OK. So it will give you this thing. Now if you run this, then you can have this kind of output. So this way you start quickly to prepare your Beamer file. And this is your title page. Then there is a command begin frame and then frame title. For example, I write down introduction. And you write down anything in this frame. And if you run it, what you will have, you will have second page, which is introduction. So you can similarly add third frame and fourth frame and many frames. So this is a way how to do things which we can do if you have this kind of preamble. So I am showing my first day slide with you, that how I prepared that. Some part of that I am going to share with you. So see, this was the first day slide. Role of LaTeX in scientific writing, my name and logo of my university and my address and date. So how to prepare this with logo? The command is here. I have used document class 11 point Beamer. Then whatever here is written, these are the different themes which usually I don't use, but if I want to use, I will comment this theme. For example, I will comment this theme and I can use another theme. If I run it, it will give me different output. You can see. So just one change will give you a new look of your presentation. So it is up to you which you like. So I usually like the Cambridge US theme. So I use that, but there are lots of themes. If you want to use them, you can Google it. There are many themes available on Google. You have to just change this package, use package. If you change it, your theme will different. Similarly, I am using package GraphicX because I want to include some I am using set Beamer color. You can have your colors also. For example, I have named the color EECKS2. This is the name of the color which I have given. And BG stands for background. So I want background to be yellow, and FG is the foreground, which is blue. I will show you where I have used this color. Then you use package color. Then text positioning. Text positioning is and red right. This is used when you want to position your text or justify your text within a Beamer. Now you see, I have written title in two brackets. One is the square bracket, which is optional one, and second is the curly braces. So whatever you write down in a square bracket, that comes here. That comes here. See, role of LaTeX in scientific writing. This is the title which you write down the square brackets, and whatever you are writing in curly braces, that comes here. So if you want to, for example, if your title is very long, then you can put a short form here, which will be shown in every slide. Then you can write down the date similarly. So date with options. So one is given here and another is given on the right bottom side, you can see. So this actually, the last line will be displayed in every slide. Similarly, you can write down the author name. So I have given the author name, Dr. Amit Kumar Mishra, and in square brackets, I have given my email ID. So this email ID will be shown at every frame in the presentation. So you can, this is not necessary that you write down whatever you are writing in curly braces, you should write down that in square bracket. That is not necessary. And then I have include graphics, which is my logo of the university. So this is the logo I have included. Just after the name of author, you can see, I have written the author name and I have provided some space and then included the logo of the university. And then I have given the address of the institute. Again, see the optional, I have written BBAU. And that option is here. It comes here with my email ID. So this is the way you prepare your title page. So I repeat once again, you provide your title, then you provide date, then you provide name. See, date will always come here. Wherever you provide it, it will always come at the last position. Provide your name, provide the logo, your institute name with options if you want them to be here at last bottom line. So this was, you have given all of them before begin document. Remember that. You just provide all these things before begin document. Now, after begin document, what I am actually doing, I am fixing this frame title. You can see I am fixing my logo here also. I want the university logo on each slide, so I am fixing it with some text block. Text block means it provides a block of some desirable length and width. You can see I have provided the length and width and the position, and then I have included the logo here. And then make title. Make title means the first page. So now you can see my second page is what is tech. So this is the begin frame. The environment is begin frame and end frame. Then you write down the frame title. So I have written frame title, what is tech. And then I have provided something which within itemize command. So you just provide begin itemize. We have seen this yesterday with justifying command. Justifying command means you want to justify these text in this slide. And then you write down items inside. And yesterday I have discussed, for example, I want Donald Knuth to be in blue color. The command is very simple. Text blue and Donald Knuth. Remember that this will only work when you use color package. Otherwise, it will not work. Now, you can see I have written all these things. There is a mathematical symbols. I will discuss how to type mathematical symbols. And then you can end the frame. Then you can start next frame. For example, I have started next frame installation. So, this is the title of the frame. Again, it contains some items. So you write down begin itemize, end itemize with justifying. Now you can see tech live, and then there is a footnote. So how to put footnote? You just write down live, and just after you write down footnote. And whatever footnote you want to display, write down that inside the curly braces. It will be displayed at the bottom of the frame. You can see here. Similarly, I have put footnote on MicTech. So that is footnote. I have given the address here. It comes here. And similarly, the footnote for the third one. So it will automatically provide 1, 2, 3 numbers. So you don't bother about numbers. You don't bother about the settings. Just provide the footnote. So this was the frame. Now, if you want to include graphics, I have discussed yesterday. The method is same. Begin frame, the title of the frame. Then begin figure, and whatever graphics you want to include, just include them. And I wanted to include them in two lines, so I have put line break here. So then this is where you can have some extra features. So I am using the Beamer box. So remember I have defined here this set beamer color, background yellow and foreground blue. So you can see background is yellow and whatever you are writing that is in the blue color. So so you start your frame, begin frame, document class, and then begin beamer color box. This is the command, beamer color box, and whatever you write down, so beamer color box, and this is the color of the beamer color box, EECKS, which I have defined at the starting position. And then you can have some options. For example, rounded is equals to true. So you can see the corners are rounded of the corners of the box are rounded. And shadow, you can see whether you want shadow or not. So you can see here is shadow. So you have written shadow is equals to 2. So it will provide a shadow. If you remove shadow, if you write down shadow is equals to false, it will remove the shadow. So there are many options. This is just an introduction of these things. When you are familiar with the basic things, then you can go through the manuals for some advanced changes. And the last is thank you. So how you write down this? You use color blue, and I am using huge thank you. Then I am using the picture. So remember that whatever pictures you are using, they must be first put in the same folder. For example, this package you must know what is the meaning of this command so that you can have changes according to your need and choice. So this was about beamer presentation, so reference and beamer. Now I will discuss very important thing, how to prepare books. So I will show you a folder where I have prepared books. So there is a folder BBD and day 3, and here is a folder of book template. So this actually, this template is of my own book. I have just extracted some part of that book to show you how to type a book. So you can see it contains many tech files. All these blue files are tech files, 2005, 2006, 2007, and then there is a PDF book, and then there is a book which is tech file, education, which is a tech file, ISBN, which is a tech file, preface, and TOC. TOC means table of contents. So these are the tech files. If you have many chapters, you can write down. For example, in my book, the chapter name I have given 2005, and the second chapter is 2006, and the third chapter is 2007. So how to prepare chapters and other things in a book, I will show you here. So you can see, first you write down document class 10. Open any. What is the meaning of open any? Open any means the new chapter will be open on left side as well as on right side, because sometimes it is required that some people say that my new chapter must open on the left side only, sorry, right side only. That means this page which is on your right hand side. So if you write down open any, then your new chapter can be started from anywhere. And then you are writing two-sided. So what is the meaning of two-sided? Two-sided will give you pages which have on odd numbered pages. Odd numbered pages will have left margin, which is in comparison more than the right margin. And your even numbered pages will have right margin more than the left margin, so that after printing, binding will be easy. So that is the two side. So I have written document class. Then I have used many packages. See, all these packages may not be useful for you, but since my book contains many things, so I have used many packages. So I will not explain every package. Then what you have, main thing, so these are the packages actually. All these are packages. Then I have fixed paper width, 9 inches. That means what will be the width of my paper, that is 9 inches. Paper height, 11 inches. Text width, so see, paper width is 9 inches. That means it is the width of the paper. And in that paper, you will write down matter in 6.75 inches. Similarly, paper height is 11 inch and you write down the text in 9.5 inches because other things will be in margin. And then this was the package geometry. You have to write down this. And now I will focus on this color, which is black. Then you write down the title, whatever title you want to write down. You just write down the title of your book. Then you write down the authors, author one and author two. And then you make title. So see now, next I am writing input ISBN. Why input ISBN? See, there are two methods. Whether you type everything in the main file, so that will be very bad when you edit it, because if your main book contains 10 chapters or 20 chapters and you are typing all those chapters here only, then it will be very difficult when you want to edit it. So it is always better to prepare chapters separately and just call all those things here in the main file. So I am calling actually ISBN which I have prepared. So I will show you what is the ISBN. So this is the book template. You can see there is a file ISBN. So this is the file ISBN. And if I run it, then it will be more good for you. So I just run it and show you, then I'll explain. So see, first thing is the title, author one, author two. So this I have written here, title. So you can write down title here. Whatever you will write down, that will come here. And you write down the author's name, that will come here. So this is your first title page. Then the second page is ISBN. What ISBN? ISBN means it contains, once again, the title, authors and their addresses and the copyright form and ISBN. So I have given this ISBN name. You can have any name. You can write down the copyright name. So this is the ISBN. And this, I have this page, I have prepared separately here. You can see this page is style empty because I do not want any page number, any head, any foot in this page. This page style is empty. Then you provide a vertical space of 10 centimeters. So I have provided a vertical space of 10 centimeters. Then I have written in boldface title. Then I have provided the vertical space of 0.8 millimeter. Then I have written the author affiliation. Then again, vertical space, author two, affiliation two. Then again, a vertical space and copyright and text copyright. This is a symbol which is here, C 2008. And then whatever you want to write down here, write down. Then there is ISBN. So this file I have prepared separately. Remember that this file do not start with the document class. That is important. So there is no need to start this file with document class because this is not a separate file. You are going to use this file into your main file. For just like you have prepared a reference file. So if you remember, reference file also have not started from document class. So you just prepare your ISBN file and call that file here. So I have called it, and the command is input ISBN. Then your book may contain dedication. So you prepare your dedication page separately. So I have prepared dedication page also. I will show you. So this is where is the dedication page? Yeah, this is the This is the dedication page. So this is the dedication page, and I have actually written this. And this is up to you how you represent your dedication. That is up to you. So. So that is the dedication page, second page which you call in your input, then clear double page. So after dedication page, you want a separate single page which contains nothing. So you write down clear double page, then you have your page numbering Roman. Now see, title page will not contain any page numbering. Your ISBN and copyright page also does not contain page numbering. Dedication will also not contain page numbering. But from preface, you may have page number in Romans. So actually, this is not shown page number here because I have just written one page. So I have not completed things. So it will provide you page numbers in Roman if you write down more than one page. So now page numbering starts with Roman, then you include preface. So I have included preface. That means I have separately prepared a file for preface. So that file is here. See, I have written chapter preface so that this preface comes. And then I have written this page style plain and write down the preface. So it is up to you how you write down your preface. So it is totally up to you. Then you write, I have written my name with using begin plus write command. You remember that we have used this command when we were preparing the certificate. So this command is plus write, you can use here. And then without indent, you write down the date. So this way you have prepared the preface and you call this preface page into your main document. Then you start, after preface, you will always have contents of the book. So remember that yesterday we have used table of contents. So you don't bother about typing contents. There is no need to type contents. You just write down include TOC. So because I have prepared separate file for content. So see this file. I have just written table of contents. So I have prepared a separate file in which I have written / table of contents, which gives you this. Now, you want to include this in your main file, just write down include TOC. So when you include TOC, it will give you this automatically. You don't bother about page numbers and this setting. What it provides you the chapter name and all sections and subsections of that chapter. It will provide you that. So you see, the chapter 1 contains question and solutions of IIT JAM MS 2005. It contains two sections. Chapter 2 contains one subsection, and it contains two subsections. So it will provide you a table of contents, and there is no requirement to do many things. You just write down a command table of contents. It will provide all the contents on the So this was the thing. Then again, I am preparing the make title because again, I may require the title page. Then start the chapter. So how you start the chapter? See, I have written page numbering Arabic because when you start your chapter, up to starting the first chapter, these numbers comes into Roman, then it usually comes in Arabic. So you just have given the command here, page number Roman. So to this function, this command, you again provide the command page numbering Arabic. Now page numbering will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kind of thing, and then you include all your chapters. For example, I have included chapter 2000, include chapter 2005, then 2006, then 2007, and whatever chapters. If you have 20 chapters, just write down include all those chapters and end document. So I have prepared these chapters separately. So I will show one of the file. So this is the chapter 2005. So how you prepare chapter? See, it contains chapter 1, then it contains the title, and then sections and the material. So you just start with chapter. See, chapter. This command is required. And write down the title of the chapter. And if you want to label it. Then you write down the section and whatever you want to type within that. So this way you prepare different chapters. Remember that again, these other files, chapter, TOC, preface, dedication, they do not require document class because they are not main files. Our main file is this file. Our main file is book file. And in this main file, you are calling all other files. So all your packages or everything that you want to use, they must be in the main file, not in other files. And in main file, you just call all these chapters which you want to include. And when you run this main file, it will automatically take care of everything which you have included. So it will give you chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, and so on. Excuse me. So this is the way you prepare your book. So there are many formats in which you can prepare your book. I have shown you one of them, which I have used to prepare my book. You can have other formats by searching on Google. So remember that why I am again and again telling you that you search on Google, because LaTeX has very vast and it has many things. So I am just introducing you the basic things. If you want advanced things, then you have to just first understand the basics and then explore on your own. So this was about how to type a book. Then I will move towards, I will share this template file with you so that you can have practice. So this was the book. Now, since we are facing COVID-19 pandemic, and most of the time we are teaching online. So some teachers may want to have online test also, or something which student can have written and send back to you. So there is a very interesting package, which is EQ exam package. EQ exam. So this package allow you to prepare question papers online. And if you have support with the technical team, that means you have your own server or you can buy some space on the server, then you can have online exam. You can conduct your online exam. So I am not going to discuss how to conduct online exam, but I am going to discuss how to prepare question paper, which can be used online using LaTeX. So, because I have taken one test using this EQ exam package, and this may be useful for you when I explain you. Before I explain you, I run it, and then I will explain you one by one about this So when you run it, it gives you this kind of file, this kind of output in LaTeX. But if you see the original output, I will show you the original output and I'll discuss then. So the original output is see the PDF. See, this is the file. When you run this file, it will generate many files, and in the same folder you will get PDF file. So someone was asking yesterday that, sir, I am not getting the PDF file. I do not know what is the problem, because PDF file and other file will always be saved in the same folder. So you just open this file, and if you share this file with anyone, any of your student, so what they will get this way. So see, they will get this kind of file. So you can see this contains. See, when you are seeing this file here in tech, it is not shown in that fashion. But when you see the PDF file, you can see, you can write down within PDF. So you can write down your name here. You can write down the question is the first president of United States. Here, write a brief history of United States. You can write down the answer here. That means the student can write down the answer here. And what is the in what year the did Columbus sail the ocean? You can select the answer. For example, I selected this answer. Then a student can save this file and send back to you, and you can check answers manually. But if you have support from your technical team and you have something on server, then the answers can be checked automatically on the server, but that requires some technical support. But it is very good if you want to just take objective questions and true false kind of answers or one word answer. But in social sciences, it may not be very useful. So in social sciences, question number three type of things may be there. So a student can answer here. A student can write down the answers here. You can see, I can write down the answer here. So this is the way you can prepare. Now I'll show how to prepare it. So this is the output and why the output is important. And now I will show. So when you close it, it will ask you, do you want to save it? I don't want to save it. If I save it, then I can send it to my teacher. If that kind of thing. So now I am going to discuss how I prepared this question paper, because that may help you in this kind of online situation. So the document class is again article. There is no problem. You have to use a package, and the name of package is EQ exam. And you can see I have written many options here. See, remember, with every package you have options. So I have written option number one, online. Online means you can have this PDF. If you can put this PDF on server, you can have online test for paper. That means you can also print this on the paper. Points on both the sides. Points on both the sides. You can see the question number one is of 5 points. So 5 is on left side also, 5 is on right side also. So that option is points on both the sides. You can remove one of them. Use forms. Okay. And then no solutions. No solutions means when you are running it, it is not providing you solution. For example, if I uncomment it and again I will run it. So you can see what happens. It gives you no solution. That means this check boxes will not be there. These kind of things will not be there. Now, if you want to see the answers also, so just uncomment is proofing, means it will provide you answers also. So see, the first president of United States is George Washington. This is the answer. True, false. Here I have not given any answer, so it is not providing you the answer. And see, 1492 is the correct answer. So if you want to see or you want to check whether your question paper is okay with every answer is correct. You just see uncomment proofing. If because you cannot send this to your students, that's why you put percent here, and when you put percent here, it will not show the answers. So now this was the use. Now how I prepare it, that is also important. So first thing is always you write down the title. So see, title is test 2. So I have written test 2 and short title is T2. Then I have written the author. Author, that means instructor, Dr. A.K. Mishra. Then I have written subject. Subject is here, MS201, that means subject code. Then date, April 23, 2020, because I have taken this test on that day. And then you start your document. So when you start your document, you first make the title, then you start begin exam. And last is end exam. See, begin exam and end exam. Now in between that, you are writing part one, because you may have part one, part two, part three of your exam. Actually, this file contains only one part, but I will explain all of them. So first, when you start your exam, first you provide the instructions to the students. So write down those instructions. All questions are compulsory and all those things. So see, these instructions come here. And automatically, it will also show you the total number of points associated with question, with this question paper. You can see 5, 4, 7, and 5. This... So this is actually 4 points each. That means 8. So total points are 8. So if you sum all these, it will give you 25 points. So it will automatically give you this here in instruction. So after instruction, you start your problem. So the command is begin problem and end problem. So I am writing the first problem. So what is my first problem? First problem is my of 5 marks. So it is written as 5 here. It represents the points. Then you are writing your question. The first president of United States is, then you are writing fill in 2 inches. Actually, you are providing this length of this line, that this is 2 inches. Then you write down the correct answer in curly braces, George Washington. So you are actually writing the correct answer for yourself. You are not going to share this with the students. So you are writing your the correct answer here. Then begin solution. So begin solution and solution, whatever solution you want. Okay. Then you start, then you end this problem. Again, you start begin problem with a star. Why star? Because it is going to have part A and part B. So if your question contains more than one part, then you put a star here. And then you provide marks for each part. So you can see this is 4EA. So this is actually marks for each part. Then you start, this question is true, false. So you start text italics true or text italics false. Now you start begin parts. So begin parts, item, item. So this is backslash true, false F, backslash true, false true. So what you are writing actually here? In curly braces, whatever you are writing, that is the answer. That is the correct answer. So what you are writing? You are writing backslash true false. It will give you a line, horizontal line. And inside bracket, you are writing false. That means you are giving the answer that this statement is false. So when you want to check it and you want to proof it, then this answer will come automatically. So this was how to prepare true false. Then how to prepare question number 3 with some space in which student can answer. So the question is begin problem. It has 7 marks. Write a brief history. Begin solution. See chapter 2 of the text. You can write down the solution here and end problem. Okay. So see, I have not written anything here. I have written begin solution 3 inches. So it will provide you 3 inches vertical space for writing the solution. Okay, then you can add multiple choice questions also. So it contains begin problem, and this has four options. So you ask your question, in what year did Columbus sail the blue? Then begin answer. So answer, it contains six columns. Actually, six columns are not required. It only required four columns. So you just change it in four columns. Then you write down begin choice. So B choice, add E choice. That means end choice. And then you write down answer. Answer with zero or answer with one. One means it is the correct answer. So you start answer zero and write down the option and / E answer. That means end of the answer. But this is a wrong answer because it contains answer zero. Similarly, you provide your second option. Similarly, you provide your third option. And you can see I have changed answer one. Answer one means this is the correct answer. So similarly, you can write down the solution. So this was the way by which you can prepare question papers, and which will have a PDF version, and you can send that PDF version to your students, and your student can solve or write down in that PDF only and save it, and they can send back to you, and then you can manually check the answers. So this is very useful in current situations because we want this kind of things. So now I will come to the last thing, which is actually how to type mathematics. Why I have pushed it at last, because many of you may not be from the mathematical background. So I pushed it at last. So now I will discuss how to type mathematics, and I will quickly discuss how to type chemistry also. So for typing chemistry, you can use mathematical equations also, and some other packages which are specifically prepared for the chemistry part. So first I'll see typing mathematics. So I'll just typed everything. So I'll explain you, because that will be very important, because it will not waste our time. So now you can see I have started with section one. So first thing is, how many what are the packages which we want to type mathematics? So you see document class article is there. Then there is a package AMS SIMB, that means American Mathematical Society Symbols. So this is a package which we require to type mathematical symbols. Then AMS Math. So this is a package which contains many mathematical commands and environment which will be useful for us. Then there is a package, use package Math SFS. This is for font style. Verbatim is not required for you. UScript is again a package for different fonts. Then declare math operator, I will discuss what is this. Then number within equation. This is very important. That means when you are writing an equation, so how you want that equation will have number. So you are writing that number should be within section. That means number should be section wise. For example, if this is the first section, first subsection, and if you are writing an equation here, then it will give you 1.1. That means equation number one from section number one. So you are writing number within equation section, so it will give you the equation number according to sections. Then you start begin document. Then I have written section, then subsection. Now you start first thing, in text math. What does it mean, in text math? See, when you are writing a sentence, and within a sentence you require mathematics, that we call in text math. So for example, a statement is, the equation representing a straight line in the Cartesian plane is of the form ax plus by plus c is equals to 0, where A, B, C are constants. So you can see here you are writing English and then mathematics and then English and then mathematics. So that means in text you are writing mathematics. So the idea is very easy. If you want to write anything in mathematical form and it is in text, just use dollar notation. So you can see I am writing the equation represent a straight line in the Cartesian plane is of the form, then I am using dollar. You can see within dollar I am writing ax plus by plus c is equals to zero. So you can see here I have not given any space between ax and plus and anywhere I have not provided a space. But what LaTeX will do, LaTeX will automatically provide spaces here. You can see LaTeX has provided a space before plus sign and after plus sign. Similarly, it has provided a space before equal sign and after equal sign. So this is the inbuilt spaces which LaTeX provides when you type mathematics. And how LaTeX recognize this? See, these plus, minus, multiplication is equals to, all of them are binary operations. If you know the mathematics, then they are called binary operations. So all the binary operations will have some space before it and after it. This is the inbuilt in LaTeX, one thing. And second thing is, if you can see, whatever is written in English and whatever is written in mathematics, the font style is different. Mathematical AX and BY and C, they are italics and they are in a different style. So it will give us a separate look and a beautiful look of mathematical equations, mathematical things within text. So whenever you want to write mathematics, you just use dollar before and dollar after. Similarly, I am writing where A within dollar, then comma B within dollar, then comma C within dollar. So this is the way you write down mathematics in text. Now you want to write down same thing as this way. The equation representing a straight line in the Cartesian plane is of the form AX plus BY plus C is equals to zero, where A, B, C are constant. So if you want to write down in this fashion, this is known as displaying equation. That this is known as display math. So if you want to display something, that means display some mathematical item separately, then you just spend one more dollar. So just spending one more dollar before and after, the equation will be displayed. So when you spend one single dollar, it will give you this kind of situation. When you spend one more dollar, the situation will be better than the previous one because you are spending one more dollar. So when you use double dollar, that will be that will show you how the display equation is there. Now superscripts and subscripts, how you put superscripts and subscripts, again they are very straightforward. Subscripts, see I am writing n greater than 2. So see here, this is the command. You are writing dollar, then n, then greater than sign, then 2. Again, you can see you have not given any space between n greater than n 2, but output you have a space, because again greater than is a kind of binary operation and LaTeX provides a space before and after it. So these are the important things about LaTeX. That means you don't bother about spaces and presentation style. It will give you. Now if you want to write down this way, x to the power n plus y to the power n is equals to z to the power n. That means you want superscript. So you just use hat symbol, which is just above your key number 6. So this is the way you write down here. Now you see, this is a display equation. And here I am not using dollar sign, because display equation can also be written using backslash square bracket. So I always prefer backslash square bracket, because they are adjacent on your keyboard. If you see your keyboard carefully, then backslash sign and square brackets are adjacent. So I always prefer this method to display any equation in LaTeX. So how you write down this? So you just write down X, then you write down this hat and then N, then plus, then Y to the power N is equals to Z to the power N. So in this way, you write down. If you write down this way, X to the power M to whole power N, so you can write down, start with bracket, then X to the power M, then end with bracket and then N. Or you can write down X to the power MN. Remember that if you want to write down this way, X to the power MN, then M and N both must be in the same curly braces. Both must be in the same curly braces. Because if you write down in this way, for example, below, you can see X to the power MN, but you have not put M and N in same curly braces, then it will read X to the power M only. And it will consider N as a multiplication in X to the power M. And the output will be this, X to the power M multiply by N. Because LaTeX will not consider N if you do not put curly braces with both. So that means if you are putting something in superscript or subscript, if you want to write down more than one thing, you must use curly braces. So similarly, you can have power to the power, for example, 2 to the power 2 to the power n. You can write down 2 to the power, and then in that power, you want to write down 2 to the power n. So that should be in curly braces. So remember that how you write that, that is also important. For example, x to the power xmn. So lower means this. X underscore 1. So if you write down X underscore 1, it will give you X 1. Similarly, if you write down X underscore 2, it will give you X 2. So now question arises when we want both. That means we want superscript as well as subscript. Then what to do? The answer is you use both without considering the sequence. For example, if you write down X underscore M, then power N. So this will consider that you are writing this power only on X. Or you write down power first, X to the power N, then underscore M. So it will consider the same thing. But if you write down in curly braces, XM to the power N, then it will give you this, XM to the power N. It is different thing. Otherwise, So if you are writing this, there is no need to bother about first you write subscript or superscript. There is no problem. You can write down both. Now you can use roots. The command is very simple. You just use sqrt, backslash sqrt 2. So it will give you square root 2. If you want to write down square root x plus y, just write down x plus y within a curly braces. Sometimes you may write down fourth root of 5, for example. Then you just provide a space, an option. So you want to write down fourth root. So you just provide optional argument 4. So this is the optional argument 4, which you are providing to a square root. Or you can write down optional argument here. So to this, to get this. Now, can we write down this way? That means square root inside. Yes, you can always use square root many times within that. So just you should take care of the curly braces. That is important. For example, I want to write down this second term. So this is 2 square. Second term is 2 square. Then square root, and within this biggest square root, you are writing 2 minus square root 2. So you just use curly braces as you use in mathematics to represent inside things. So you can write down these things. Now, mathematical symbols, I have explained you that there are binary operations kind of things. So there are some inbuilt operations in LaTeX. If you are using those inbuilt operations, then LaTeX will provide a space before it and after it. But if you want to use something extra, some other symbol which is not inbuilt in LaTeX, then you have to tell the LaTeX that I am going to use the symbol for what purpose. So I'll explain you this with this one example. What it says, there is a symbol circle, dollar CIRC. This is a symbol which gives you a circle. Okay, so LaTeX consider it as a binary operation. So if you want to use this symbol, for example, you are writing X / CIRC, and then you are providing a space Y. Why the space is needed here after the command? Because if you do not provide a space, then it will consider that the command is / CIRCY. This is the command, but there is no such command. So after command, you must provide a space, because whatever you are writing after the command, if you do not provide a space, it will consider that as a part of command and it will provide you error. So what I am writing, X without any space is starting. There is no need of a space. X without any space circle, then you are providing a space X and so on. So what it will give you, see, there is no need to provide spaces here. If I remove these spaces, output will remain same. So you can see there is a space before and after circle. Why? Because circle is also a binary operation in LaTeX setting. So whether you provide a space or not, it will take care by the LaTeX. Now, if you want to use some other symbol which is not inbuilt in LaTeX, for example, I want to use box. This is the command box, and I want to use box here instead of circle. So if you write down X / box Y, and you just write down X square plus Y square, for example, and if you run it, you can see there is no space before and after box. Why there is no space before and after box? Because this box is not inbuilt for binary operation in LaTeX. So LaTeX will not provide spaces here because this is not inbuilt. But if you want to provide a space here also, you just tell the LaTeX that this box is not a simple box. This is a binary box. So the command for write down that math bin, that means it is a binary operation of mathematics. So if you provide this math bin just before box, then LaTeX will consider this box as a binary operation, and it will provide a space before and after, and that will be automatic space. So this is the idea. Now, for example, you are using this box many times in your thesis or in your article. So if you are using same thing many times, and then you will waste time if you type every time math bin box. That will waste your time. So in similar way, there are in statistics, for example. In statistics, we most of the time write down let x1, x2, xn be a random sample. So x1, x2, xn, we most of the time write it. In mathematics, if you write down x1, x2, dot, dot, dot is a real sequence, or a1, a2, dot, dot, dot is a real sequence. So these things which are actually repeated many times, you always can do. You can custom your command. You can write your own command in LaTeX. So the second thing is this is the how to customize command. So I will explain this slowly, because this is a new thing and this is a very important thing, because it saves your time. When you know how to customize your own command, that will always give you more time for other works. So how we provide commands, look at, I have given the commands here, but if you want these commands in whole of the document, you should define these commands in preamble. Preamble means whatever you are writing before begin document. So you should write down these things there. So what, how we write down? So first we understand the meaning. So the command is / new command. Then it will have two arguments. First curly braces. This curly braces will have name of the command which you provide, whatever you want. So for example, I have given the name / VECT. Remember that / is required because every command starts from / then you provide any name which is not a default name. For example, I cannot write down here something which is already defined in LaTeX. That we can, that you cannot do. So you want to write down new command vect, and then in second curly braces you should write down what you want. I want, for example, I want this output x1 x2 dot 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 xn. So I will write down this here, brackets x_1, x_2, now see, you have three dots here. So the command is / dots. The command is / dots and then xn. So you have defined your command. Now whenever you use / VECT, it will always give you this. So for example, we often write x to denote vector, and now you can see I have written $VECT. So this VECT, /VECT, we have defined. So whenever you write down VECT, the output will automatically x1, x2, xn, automatically, because you have defined this. Now, many times you need x1, x2, xn, y1, y2, yn, yeah, x1, x2, xm. That kind of things, that means you want to write down, instead of x, you want to write down y. Instead of last n, you want to write down m. So that can also be done if you extend your command by defining the variables also. So now I am defining a command, new command, / vect pt, this is the name, and I am writing one variable, optional. Optional means there is a one variable. And what is one variable? So see, #1 represents the first variable. So what you want #1 with _1. So instead of #1, you may have x, you may have y. So it will provide you x1, y1 kind of thing. Then #2, then dots, then #1n. So when you write down vect, inside you write down x. So this x is the variable. So it will give you, it will replace all the #1 with x. So it will give you x1, x2, dot, 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 xn. And if you write down y instead, it will give you y1, y2, yn. So x1, x2, xn, y1, y2, yn. So remember that the same command with variables give you different answers. So if I replace this ym, it will give me m1, m2, mn. You can see it will give me m1, m2, mn. So this saves a lot of time of hours. But if you want two variables, for example, so you just write down new command vect 2. Now first variable, okay, at last, that means if at this position you want n or you want m, so at last position you just put your second variable. So similar, this way you can define commands. Now how to provide single equations? The equation command is begin equation and end equation. So if you write down begin equation with a star, star means it will not give the number to your equation, and you can have this kind of thing. So why we use begin equation and end equation? Because if you want to write down this, we can write down this using double dollar. So if you have any doubt, that means in future you may require equation number to this equation, then always choose begin equation and equation, because when you remove this star, if you remove this star, it will provide you equation number. See, it will provide you equation number. So it is always better to have something written in begin equation, end equation environment. If you have any doubt that in future you may have a requirement of the equation number, then always prefer this. Now the thing is, if you want to write something in text within equation, for example, I have written or here, or, so you just write down text within equation, within mathematics you can write down text for writing English, and within English you use dollar for writing mathematics. And you can see quad is providing the space before and after. So these are the things. Now the second thing is, if you want to split equation, so you can split equation using this command begin split and end split. So now remember, whenever you are splitting something, you have to use the alignment ampersand, because it will align these three things here. You can see the equal to aligns, because after alignment you are writing equal to, here after alignment you are writing equal to, here after alignment you are writing equal to. So equal to will be aligned. Now if you want to write down many equations simultaneously, then the best thing is use align environment, begin align. So for example, if I just put here percent and then I'll show you what is it gives you. So begin align, you are writing x plus y minus z is equals to 1 and so on kind of thing. So the command, the environment is begin align, end align, and you write down the first portion and then ampersand, which is an alignment command, and is equals to 1. So all these things. But if within alignment you also need a text, so you just write down intertext. So when you write down intertext, this intertext will appear within the alignment, and alignment will not be disturbed. See, there is something written, but alignment has not been disturbed. Okay, so you can align more than one also. So here we are aligning two times. See, first I have aligned at equal to 1, then second I have aligned here also. So I have aligned two times, first alignment here at equal and second alignment at here. So you can use many alignments, just like you are using in tabular form. Then there is a very important thing, which is this. Many times we need this. So this is, the command is, if you want to write down, for example, mod x is equals to x minus x when x is this, otherwise. This is required many times in mathematics. So how you write down? This is actually cases. So the command is begin cases. So you start begin cases, it will automatically provide curly braces. Then you write down x, then you align it, and you write down text, which is if, and inside text you write down mathematics. Otherwise you can write down minus x, and you write down separate text if and x less than 0. So this is using begin cases, you can write down this way. Now numbered equations, you know that for numbering you just remove the star. So without a star, if you are writing begin equation, end equation, it will provide you number. Sometimes you want to change the number. So if you want to change the number, just write down tag. So within tag, whatever you write down, so you are writing tag L. So whatever you write down in tag, the equation will become that. For example, if you do not want braces here, so you just write down tag star. You can see tag star. So if you write down tag star, it will remove the remove the parenthesis. But if you are using align, and within align, since you have two equations, then this will provide you equation number to both of them. But sometimes you may not require the equation number to both of them. Then if you do not want equation to be given on the second line, then the command is very simple. You just use no tag after the second line. So if you use no tag, it will remove the equation number from the second part. Okay. But if you are not using alignment and you are using begin equation and using begin split, then it will provide a single equation number to all of them, because there is a single equation. There is no more equations. There is a single equation. You are splitting that equation. That is your way of representation. But there is a single equation, so it will provide a single equation number. So as we have already mentioned that whenever there is a number, you can always label it and always use that. For example, if I label it, for example, EQ1. So I can use here C equation refer EQ1. So if you write down here and run it, C equation 3.5 here. So that is always there. Whenever there is a number which is automatic in LaTeX, you can always label them, you can always refer them. Now there are many other things in mathematics, so I will quickly discuss those things. So for example, you want to write down matrix form. So the command is begin P matrix. Begin P matrix means parenthesis matrix. So you just write down begin P matrix. It will provide you parenthesis. Then you write down first row. How you write down first row? For example, first row is 1, 1, minus 1. So you write down 1, then alignment, then 1, then alignment symbol, then minus 1, and break the first row. Then you write down the second row with alignment symbols and break the second row. Then you write down the third row with alignment symbol and do not break the third row, because end P matrix will automatically break the third row. So if you want to write down matrices in parentheses, the command is begin P matrix and P matrix. But sometimes you require parentheses, sometimes you require matrices in square brackets. So if you want to require matrices in square brackets, just remove this with B matrix. So if you remove this with B matrix and run it, you can see this is a square matrix. This is with a square bracket. So just removing B, just replacing B with P with B, it gives you a bracket. If you want, instead of matrix, if you want a determinant, so write down V matrix. So when you write down V, V means vertical, then it will give you determinant. Okay. And if you write down capital B here, then it will give you curly braces here. Okay. So that means you just change something and it output will change. So if you put here capital V, it will give you two vertical lines. So these are required in mathematics. So I am just writing parenthesis here. So other examples are written below also. Determinant, curly braces, all these. So I have discussed all of them. So I will discuss this once more. For example, you want to write down a matrix. So A11, A12, dot, dot, dot. So this dot, dot, dot is actually your third column. So you write down begin P matrix, and within P matrix, you are writing A11, then A12, and then in third column, you are writing dots, and in last column, you are writing this. So this is first row. Similarly, you write down the second row. Now your third row. So there is nothing in third row. In third row, there is a dots. So the command is H dots for. H dots means horizontal dots. For what? For four columns. So there are four columns. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this 4 represents the number of columns. And this 2 represents the space between these two dots. So if you remove this, space will reduce. So this way you can write down. Now there are many kind of dots which are very important. So if you write down something x1, x2, dot, 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 and x1 plus x2, then if you see here dots are on the bottom, which is actually not good when you are typing mathematics. Dots should be just at the center. Similarly, if you are writing product, dots should be at center. So there are different dots. So if you are writing dots, simple dots, then they are known as dots C. Dots C means dots which are used after comma. And similarly, dots B, dots which are used after binary operations, for example, plus minus. And there is a dots M, which is used for product kind of things. That means dots which we put on middle. And similarly, integration. So how you put integration? The command is INT. So you are writing INT underscore. Underscore means you are putting something here. So you are writing A1. And again INT. And then you need a dot. So there is a dots I. Dots I means which is for integration. So these are the dots. And then I will discuss one important thing, which is delimiters. So what is delimiters? If you are writing something and you want to write something on left and right, for example, brackets. We use brackets. When we use brackets, they are the delimiters. So how you write down delimiters? I quickly tell you the command. Command is begin left, backslash left and backslash right. After left and right, whatever symbol you provide, for example, I have provided a vertical symbol. So this vertical symbol will cover, you can see this vertical symbol will cover whatever is there in between these two. So this vertical symbol will cover whole thing. So you can write down vertical symbol, for example, here I am writing left then parenthesis, right then parenthesis. So it is providing us vertical symbols. So this is providing parenthesis, covering this everything, whatever is written here. But sometimes you may not require delimiters on both the sides. For example, this equation. So if you, for example, here I am requiring the delimiters on right side only, and there is no delimiter on left side. So the idea is very simple. You just put, see, I am not discussing everything. I am just discussing the main things. So you see left dot I have written. So when you put a dot, that means it will not give you any delimiter on left side. But if you remove dot, then it will provide you error, because delimiters always comes in pair. You cannot say that I will not write down the left delimiter and I will only use the right delimiter. So it will provide you error. So delimiters you have to write down. If you do not want any delimiter, just put a dot there. So these are the uses of delimiters. Delimiters means it will cover whatever is written inside. So you can have delimiters. For example, this is left curly braces, left parenthesis, right parenthesis, and so on. Now, how to write down fractions and binomial coefficients? The command is for binomial coefficients. The command is this. See, there are many things, but I am just discussing the main. So binom. So when you use binom command, so it will give you binom first argument n, second argument 1. So it will give you nc1. Okay. Now similarly, when you provide frac 1, 2, it will give you fraction 1/2. Okay, so you can provide fractions and binomials using these two commands. Now, very important thing is there. For example, if you see this expression, mod of x n less than half, and this expression, mod of x n less than half, the second looks better in comparison to first, because here half looks very big. So why this happens? Because this is in display mode. So in display mode, this fraction command, frac 1/2, is representing in display mode. But if in within an equation, for example, see, see here, this is begin equation, end equation, that means display mode, the second one. But this 1/2 is not in display mode. Why I have put here T frac? So T frac means text frac. So if you do not want something in display mode in fraction, you just put a text T frac. So T, if you are putting T, that means it is text mode. If you are putting D, for example, you are putting D, so it is display mode. So remember that if you are writing something in equation, then by default it is display mode. If you are writing something in line, by default it is text mode. So if you want to change the default setting, you just interchange all these things. So affixing symbols, I would suggest you, I will share this file. You just see how to put these things, because I have very important thing to discuss. And which, this one. And then there is one very, very important thing. So different phases of mathematics, because you want many things. So in mathematics, you can also write down normal. Normal means italics. Then you can write down Roman, math, RM. See, the command is math, RM. Then you can have math boldface. Then you can have math sans serif. You can have math typewriter, math calligraphic, many things. So even in mathematics, you can change the font. And if you want to change something, for example, alpha, beta, gamma, so you should use bold symbol. For example, I write down here alpha. So these are the commands for Greek letters, / alpha. So you can see here alpha. So these are the things. Why these are important? Means fonts are important, because international standards or organization says that vector should be in boldface, matrix should be in capital letters, and so on. So these are the things required. And even you can have this kind of notations also. So if you are doing higher mathematics, then you know that we have to write down the A, B, C in a different formats. So there are many formats. You can write down those things using math here. So see, there is a math, and here many things are written. Math equations, how many equations are there, math functions, math font styles. So see, these are the font styles. So don't you don't require to remember the commands. So these are the font styles. You just use the commands here. Then font symbols. Symbols are here. Accents are here. All the accents are here. Spacings are here. So it is not required to remember these commands. Why I am closing it? Because I have to discuss very important thing, which is how to write down how to write down theorems and their proofs. And then I have to discuss chemistry also, little bit. So I will, I hope I will take 10 to 15 minutes more. So I will discuss quickly how to type theorems. That is also very important in LaTeX, in mathematics. So if you want to write down theorems in mathematics, then command starts from here. New theorem, THM theorem. So what you are doing, you are defining THM, and whenever you write THM, it will display theorem. So see, here I have written this. New theorem, THM theorem. So whenever I write begin theorem, begin THM, see, begin THM, it will always give you theorem one kind of thing. Okay. Similarly, you can write down corollary. So you can see in corollary, I have written section here. So what section will do? Section will put the number according to section. So see, you can see theorem is written theorem 1, but corollary is written corollary 1.1. Why 1.1? Because this is in section 1 and this is first corollary of section 1. So if you remove section from here, it will not provide you 1.1 kind of thing. So if you want to also write down the name of the author or the person who has developed the theorem, then you can write down it using optional command, this begin THM Euclid in options. So it will give you Euclid here. And I think I should leave this because this, yeah, proof I should consider how to write down proof. So the environment is begin proof and end proof. So it will give you italics form this way. And if you want, when it ends, it will provide you a square bracket here. Okay. So this is the way you provide the proofs. Now there is one more thing, different styles of theorem. For example, you can see here, theorem is written in italics, but here definition is written in normal way. So there are theorem styles. So I'll discuss without this package AMS-THM, you cannot do this. So there is a theorem style which is plain. Plain means it will give you this kind of output. That means this will be in bold, head will be in bold, and the body of the theorem will be in italics. But if you want to change it, you can write down theorem style definition. So definition style will contain bold head but Roman body. Similarly, there is a theorem style remark. What it will do? It will contain italics head and Roman body. So these are different styles. You can change these styles also, but I will not discuss that because of time reason. So, but you can have, I will share this document with you. You can change the styles also. Now I quickly discuss chemistry, how to type chemistry, because that is also many of you were asking about that. So first I would like to mention you that I am not very good in chemistry, and again, I have not typed chemistry before. Only today I have gone. So I would suggest.
Dr. Mishra, I think some connectivity problem is there. Dr. Mishra.
Is it okay now?
Yeah.
Please. So there was a connectivity problem. So now I am going to discuss the chemistry, how to type chemical equations and all those things. So you can use mathematical equations also, but that will not help you for many things. So the package, so first you write down document class article, then this is the package, ChemFig. Use package ChemFig. And this package will help you to type chemistry. So there are different bonds in chemistry, single bond, double bond, and if you want many more, so these are the other bonds: single bond, double bond, triple bond, plain right cram. I do not know what is this. So these bonds, I cannot understand these bonds. So if you are from chemistry background, you can understand these bonds. And these are the commands for different bonds. So I'll just discussing two of them. So how to put this O and H with single bond and OH and with double bond. The command is very simple: / chem fig O dash H. So it will give you this output. And if you put equal to, it will give you double bond. Then many times you may require angles between different bonds in chemistry. So again, the command is chem fig. And how you provide angles? So there are three methods to provide angles. One is the default method, another is the absolute angle, and the third one is the relative angle. So the default method tells you that there is a default unit. So there is a default unit 1. And 1 unit means 45 degree from horizontal in anti-clockwise. Okay. So now you can see I start with chem fig. In curly braces I am writing A. So it will give you A here. Then I am writing dash. Dash means it will give you dash here, single line. Then I am writing in square brackets 1. 1 means the angle is of 1 unit. 1 unit means angle is of 45 degree. So you can see that from horizontal, this bond is at 45 degree. Then after this bond, you are writing B. Then again, you are writing dash. Then you are writing 7. 7 means 45 multiplied by 7. So it is 315, I think. So this angle is 315 anti-clockwise. So this is horizontal, this is 90, then 180, then 270, and then something. So this is anti-clockwise 315 degree. So these are the default settings. That means you can use 1 for 45 degree, 2 for 90 degree, 4 for 180 degree, and so on. And all the angles are measured from the horizontal with anti-clockwise sense. But if you want to provide absolute angles, that means you do not want a multiple of 45 degree, because that may not be required to you, then you use A dash, in a square bracket you write down colon. So colon means it is giving you absolute angle. Now you are writing 50. That means 50 degree angle. And then B. So you can see A and this bond is at 50 degree angle from the horizontal. Then you are writing B. Then again you are writing minus 25 degree. Minus 25 degree means from B, from horizontal, it is below the horizontal line, this C. This is minus 25 degree angle. So that angle you can mention. Now there is one more thing. In previous two cases, angles have been measured from the horizontal line, but you can have angles relative measured to the bonds. And for that, you have to use double colon. So if you use two colon, that means your angle will be measured relative to the previous bond. For example, it is writing minus 25. So you can see here, this is A, and this minus 25 is with respect to this bond. So if you extend this bond here, then this angle is minus 25. So that is the relative angle. So in chemistry, you may require rings also. So rings, the command is very simple. You start with your first element, which I am calling A here. And then you tell LaTeX that how many numbers are there. So A, B, C, D, E, that means 5 numbers are there. So you just write down A star 5. Star 5 means there are 5 numbers. Now from A to B, there is a single bond. So you write down single B, then double C, then single D, then single E, then double E. so it will provide you a ring. If you want any circle within ring, just put one more star here. That means if you put two stars, it will provide you circle also. And if you are writing star 5 and you are not providing 5 items, then it will provide you incomplete ring. Because 5 items are required and you are not providing 5 items, so it will provide you incomplete ring. Similarly, you can have branched. So branching is simple. And how to do that? See, camfig H. You start with H, then there is a line. So you just put a single here, then there is a C. So you write down C. Then after C, you have two bonds. One is above, one is below. Okay. So you provide all those two bonds in parentheses with their angles. Okay. So see, the first parenthesis include two means it is 2 times 45 degree. So you can see it is 90 degree. So first H is at 90 degree. So you are saying that there is a bond where H is written at 90 degree. Then in second parenthesis, you have again a bond where H is written at 6 into 45 degree. 6 into 45 degree means 270 degree. So there is H written below. Then you write down C. Then O is written as 45 degree and H is written as at 7 times 45 degree. So this will provide you molecular bonds. Similarly, you can use rings also to provide this thing. So even if you are using rings, the same parenthesis idea will work. So I can only discuss chemistry up to this point, because this I could understand. Beyond this, I could not understand chemistry. So it would be very difficult to explain the things, because a little bit chemistry I know. So these were the things which I wanted to cover today. Although I have quickly covered mathematical typing, but yesterday I have sent a file contains LaTeX tutorial, and that file is actually from where I have covered all these things. So you can go through that file and practice it in three days workshop. I cannot cover everything, so I have tried to cover most of the things so that you can have an idea about what we can do. So someone is sharing his or her so now I open this platform for questions. If you have any question, I would be happy to answer. And if you have any doubt, we can have discussions on email in future. And I would suggest you to go through the different manuals by which you can learn many more things about LaTeX. I have discussed only basics, but there is a vast amount of literature available about LaTeX. You can do many, many things in LaTeX. So you just practice it and try to get things which we can do. So now if there are questions, we can discuss those questions. What is the difference between split and equine array and align commands? See, split you can use within equation, and equine array is separate environment, and align is again a separate environment. So align, I always prefer align, because align is very good for gives very good output. So I always prefer align. But if you are writing a single equation, you can use a split. And if within an equation you are writing many things, then you can use equine array. So please provide your email ID. My email ID is written in my PPT of day one. You can see that below. bottom line. So how to provide limits to integration? See, limits are using underscore and superscripts. That means subscripts and superscripts. So whatever you are, see, you are providing anything below and above, always work with superscripts and subscripts. Otherwise, there is a command backslash limits also. How to remove page numbers throughout the slides while using Cambridge US theme? I have to search it because I have not done it any time. Please share your scripts. Scripts means this tech files. Yeah, so I'll share my tech files. I think I have shared 2 days tech files. Sir, please tell how to include references in presentation when we were used. See, the same method. There is no separate method. If you want to use references, I'll show you. You just write down that reference file, that bibliography file in the same thing. So I'll just, if I'll try, this will, so I'll try to provide you one example. For example, I will show you. So for example, how to provide references. So I will show you from one of my presentations how to provide references. Okay, because so this is a file. See, I have put references here. I'll show you. Yeah, see, section ref, see, I'll run it, then I'll show it to you. Because referencing is very important. So at last, there is a reference here. See, these are the references in my presentation. And how to write down that? So begin frame. Frame title is reference. Begin the bibliography. So you have to, since you are writing references here only, you just prepare your bibliography file here. So begin the bibliography and then set Beamer template, bibliography item, book. So this will show you book, and then write down bib items according to your need, and then online bib items. So it will provide you websites and so on. So this is the way you can write down bibliography in the presentation. So when I will share my presentation, I will add this bibliography in that file so that you will be able to understand more. So sir, how to refer equation number in text? See, I have told you this. Backslash refer and then key of the equation number. But Q quad will provide you more space than quad. Is there any command to write bibliography in an alphabetical order? See, bibliography will be there in alphabetical order according to the style which you are using. So you don't bother about putting them in alphabetical order. How to write long equations? See, long equations you can write down using begin align and end align. So you have to use the alignment for writing long equations. For example, you are breaking an equation somewhere. You just break it and start with a different alignment. So begin align and end align help you writing long equations. which command we can use for summation? The command is /sum. So when making presentation, can we have a problem related to length of line? You have to break the line. See, if you are writing mathematics, you have to break the line. If you are not writing mathematics, there is no problem in length of line. Give me short introduction of PPT. Why? Have you missed the lecture? Sir, please suggest how can we remove bad boxes in our text file. See, it depends upon your error. I would suggest you just Google it, because bad boxes depends upon the particular errors may be there. So I cannot discuss that, because I do not know which kind of bad boxes you are getting. So which command we use for big brackets? Just in fraction, just use delimiters, left parenthesis and right parenthesis. So someone is saying that due to network problem. So I will share my PPT with you, and going through that PPT, I'm sure you will definitely understand the presentation, how to prepare presentation, so how to provide hyperlink. So there is a package for providing hyperlink. So you can find that package on Google. There are some issues when using align command also, because when the equation lengthy and when I try to break, the first part will move completely to the right. See, that would not happen if you break it properly, because I always use the align command to write down long equations. So you have to just break it properly. Every journal have their own style referencing. Is it available package? Yeah. They will provide you referencing style also. Can we get recording that? So kindly share the link of feedback again. That is not a question. So if I missed question of anyone, please write down once again. So when writing quiz using LaTeX, can we add? Can we add time after which student can write? See, if you are putting it on server, you can do that. But manually, it is not possible. So someone is saying that Tech Live is taking a lot of time to install. So you just, I cannot say anything about it. Taking time, because it depends upon your device and many other things. Sir did not answer my question on Mendeley use in LaTeX. See, Mendeley is again a referencing package. So Mendeley gives you all the things, and you can use Mendeley in LaTeX. That I have not covered here, but the answer is yes. How to justify whole content of the PPT? So I have used justify command, but you have to use justify command within frame if you are using an environment. For example, if you are using begin itemize, then again you have to write down justify, because whenever you use an environment, then the previous commands will not work. So justify at the preamble, if you are writing in preamble, justify, it will work if you do not use environments. Otherwise, within environment, you have to write down justify. So how to get data set written in front of any reference instead of one? See, I have told you, using NatBib package, you can have author and years instead of numbers. How to add watermark? So there is a package, use package watermark, by which you can use watermark. Can you suggest me ebooks for LaTeX? I would share some of them. Can we include EndNote also in LaTeX? that I do not know because I have not used it. How to make equation one column in two column paper in LaTeX. This also I have not used. So I request you please search this on Google because that was not required at any time to me. So I have not gone through this. How to write a book with two sides typing. Just provide option two side in document class. LaTeX by Leslie Lamport is one of the good book. I will share that to you. Is it possible to create a reference file separate then use it in article? Of course, I have started my talk from this place that first we should prepare a file and then use it in our main file. Is it necessary to add dollar sign for what? If you want to type mathematics, dollar sign is compulsory. If you don't want to type mathematics, dollar sign is not required. In NetBib, we would get author and year there in our data, but I need this data set written in the list of reference. I could not get the question actually. Then I am unable to understand the question actually. How to write summation? I told you, just use backslash sum. It will give you summation sign. Sir, in NetBib, we would get author and year there in our data, okay? But I need this data set written in the list of reference instead of one. That I am saying, using NetBib, you can do that. There is a, see, remember, there are two things. One is the reference style. So by changing the reference style, you can do this. So someone is asking for product. The command is /prod. So there are these basic commands. I have shared a document, LaTeX tutorial with all of you. So that document contains all of these commands. So if you want to see, you can see from there also. Otherwise, these commands are there in math. So when you go through book or these things, the commands you can see from there, and after practicing these commands will you will remember all these commands. So Sani, sir, can you difference referencing style in PPT? Yeah, I have shown you that book. His book was in a different way. The websites I have written in a different way, so that I have shown you. So how to include image? I think you missed yesterday presentation because yesterday I have discussed how to include images. Advantages and disadvantages of Word to LaTeX converters. See, Word to LaTeX converter, I have used whenever I have used Word to LaTeX converters, I could not get correct commands in LaTeX because LaTeX commands are different, and when we convert it, it will not provide me exact things which I wanted. So is it possible to set a particular image in a presentation for a particular time? You can do that, but you have to use different packages. See, there are lots of things which you can do with LaTeX. I have just covered the introductory ideas about LaTeX. If you want to become expert of some particular area, for example, I have covered chemistry. So all of you may not be interested in chemistry. But chemistry people who are learning chemistry, they may be interested in chemistry. So you just go through the manuals, you will have all the informations. So I have just introduced basic ideas about that. So someone is writing the chemistry formula and chemical equations are generally written in CAM draw or CAM office. Do I directly insert the formula or equations in the tech file? I do not know because I have not used it. See, I have told you that I do not know chemistry very well because when I was in class 12th, I left chemistry and chose statistics because I was unable to understand chemistry fully. So I cannot answer your question. You just try to search the answer from Google. So yesterday I have said WinEdit is more good comparison to Tech Studio. See, it is a paid version. It has lots of different commands. So it is totally up to you whether you like it or not. It is a subjective matter. So I cannot say that everyone will like WinEdit over Tech Studio. It may change person to person. So I will provide whole PPT to all of you. Overleaf has some limitations over number of pages. Can we combine two tech files? See, I have not used Overleaf because I always prefer to work offline because there is no need to go to Overleaf unless and until you don't have offline possibilities. For chemistry, it is better to draw CAM draw and CAM office. It takes care of errors. So see, it may be. I don't know about much about chemistry. Graphs are plotted in LaTeX. Yeah, graphs you can plot in LaTeX. There is a TickZ package by which you can plot the graphs. So if there is no other question, then I am very thankful to all of you. Because of your continuous efforts by asking questions and engaging me. And one can only ask questions if he has listened everything. So I am again very thankful to all of you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. All the sessions were very informative. I hope our participants must have learned a lot about the role of LaTeX. Now I would like to invite Dr. Amresh Kumar, sir, professor, head and convener for Board of Things. Amresh, sir.
Hello, everyone. As we come to the close of this faculty development program, it is my pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks to all who have helped make this event possible. I would like to thank our eminent speaker, Dr. Amit Kumar Mishra, for being with us by taking his time out of his busy schedule delivering the lecture. I wish also to record our sincere appreciation to our chairperson, ma'am, president, sir, vice president, ma'am, CED, sir, vice chancellor, sir, who permitted us to organize and perform this faculty development program. I wish to thank our director for MEC, Dr. Shailen Kurmar Saraf, sir, Dr. Engineering Dr. V.K. Singh, sir, who shown keen interest in associating themselves for the activation of this faculty development program. Thanks are also due to our organizing team, which includes all head of departments, faculty members, our technical team, headed by Professor Sanjay Kumar Sharma and Professor Rituraj Jalan for their support. I thank all the participants. I believe that this faculty development program has certainly provided you an insight. To conclude, let me once again reiterate my gratitude to all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And thank you all the participants.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
This meeting will continue for 15 minutes more. So kindly fill the feedback form. This feedback form is very necessary for getting the certificate. Thanks a lot.